We have new reporting this morning on COVID long haulers who have had so much trouble shaking their symptoms. They've also struggled to find doctors who understand how to treat them. But CNN's Dr. Sanjay Gupta reports that might be changing.
Nitza Rochez felt her best when she was moving. In March 2020, the New Yorker got COVID. Just 43 years old, Nitza was young and healthy and wasn't too worried until one night in April.
I woke up in the middle of the night because of like a drumming or pounding sound. It was literally the sound of my heart. And I went to the emergency room.
What unfolded next is the story of long COVID, a story that has now been repeated millions of times in the United States. An odyssey of doctor's visits, almost all of them resulting in normal test results, despite her feeling otherwise.
I just had a lot of odd and bizarre symptoms for the next month that got progressively worse and then escalated to tremors.
You believe we're dealing with a new sort of disease here?
I think so.
Dr. Zijun Chen is medical director for Mount Sinai Center for Post-COVID Care, the first such center established in the country.
Are you able to predict who is most likely to develop long COVID?
Those patients admitted to the hospitals with the most severe symptoms during their initial illness, the risk of them having long-lasting symptoms is higher. But that doesn't mean that, you know, if you have a small fever or mild symptoms at home, that you're immune to it.
COVID's lingering impacts are vast, from the brain to our hearts. A study of patients from the VA who had COVID early on in the pandemic were 60% more likely to have developed any cardiac issues, including heart disease and cardiac arrest, a full year out.
But the idea that even if I didn't get that sick, that I could have long-lasting symptoms, I don't want to overstate this, but how frightening is that?
It's very frightening. I mean, it's like stepping up to a gambling table at Vegas and risking losing everything.
And that's what makes it all the more puzzling. It's not clear who develops long COVID, who recovers, or why it happens in the first place. Best estimates, around 30% of people who had COVID still have symptoms at least 3 months after infection.
I think the thing that surprised us the most is really just the breadth of disease. Like, why so many different symptoms?
So far, there are just theories. An overly active immune system still trying to fight the virus despite not being infected anymore. Or perhaps bits of the virus still hidden in our bodies. Or simply the wreckage from the virus that can cause things like blood clots, choking off blood supply to everything, from our nose to our toes.
I had all of these bizarre symptoms, including trembling legs and arms, could not move my legs. I started walking with a cane.
She saw multiple neurologists and cardiologists, dozens of visits with everyone, trying to address a specific organ of her body. None of it really made a difference until she got to Mount Sinai, a place she says finally focused on her as a whole patient.
Instead of being dismissed, my doctor actually could finish sentences for me on how the symptoms were affecting me.
Even here, though, there are no easy answers, and long COVID does remain a mystery. For Nitza, she did find some relief with steroids and over a year's worth of physical therapy. She still has brain fog at times, and her movement is still limited. But she's back to work and on her feet.
I can exercise compared to a year ago. I would say I'm running a marathon right now.
Now, Brianna and John, I'll tell you, there's a lot about long COVID that we still don't know, as you just heard there. Dr. Chen says we may be dealing with an entirely new disease, and we just have to take the evidence as it comes in. Lots of theories out there. The NIH is dedicating a lot of resources to understanding what's happening and what best to do to treat patients with long COVID. One bright spot that's come up in study after study is that people who are vaccinated, even after they potentially become infected, do dramatically reduce the chances that they're going to develop long COVID. It's not perfect, but it really offers some protection against the long duration of these symptoms.